Okay, for the interval based variables, what should we do? Like we have a temperature, the weight, for example. So we have the distinctness, right?
Yes, sir. No, option B could
option
be.
B.
Uh-huh, option B seems to be the best because, or you can also say D as all four properties. That's also okay. Achha, ordinal. What about ordinal in which there is a ranking?
Oh, and distinction and order.
Yeah, option distinction A. Order is okay because not. Agar wo, I mean, yeah. I can't add the ranks, right? I mean, if I am saying ke, for example, I'm saying ke, like say grade A, right? And then I'm saying grade B. So I can't add them, right? So there's a rank here, but I can't add them necessarily. I can't add them. So I can't always add them. That's the reason. So I think A is the correct response here. Okay. Okay. Right. So what are the important characteristics of structured data? Structured data is data that you have been seeing in your CSV files and database. That's called structured data. Does it have dimensionality? What do you mean by dimensionality of a structured data? Dimensionality ka kya matlab hota hai?
Row in column.
Yeah, the number of columns. So yeah, this is good. This is important. I am not really sure. What about generality? I'm not generalizing anything about it, right?
Yeah. That's an analysis bit. It's not going to be there in the data itself.
Acha, haan, theek hai. You know, in the beginning, we talked about a sample that the training data is a sample, right? Yeah, in the beginning of the course, we talked about this, that training data is a sample. Of the whole population. Ye maine aapko badi clearly bataya tha. So in that, and what we use the sample to do machine learning, BI, data warehousing, data wrangling, etc. So in that case, if I am saying it's a sample, but whatever conclusions I make about the sample, I can say ke population mein bhi yehi hota hai. Yehi kaha tha na maine inferential testing mein bhi. If you remember ke... Haan, toh in that case, I am generalizing. So basically, I am generalizing from the sample towards the population. Okay. So if we take this stance, then we can say A and B. Dekhen, MCQ mein, there is every person has his or her own way of thinking. You know, I will not say ke, in the final exam ke MCQ mein number 8 ka A answer correct tha. No, I will never be giving any key there. It depends on how you have justified your response. Theek hai? So as far as I am concerned, I will mark these two. If someone says only dimensionality, that's also the correct response. Theek hai? At least this is the most important one, which is always there. Right. Ab ye toh aap log bata dein. What are some of the common problems of data quality?
Option D, all of the above.
हाँ जी कोई और
सर डुप्लीकेट
हाँ ऑल ऑफ द अबव बिकॉज ऑब्वियसली हाँ आउटलायर्स देखिए आउटलायर इज नॉट नेसेसरली अ डेटा क्वालिटी प्रॉब्लम आउटलायर्स कुड बी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर योर एनालिसिस बट द फैक्ट इज कि यू हैव टू एनालाइज द आउटलायर सेपरेटली ठीक है सो व्हेन यू डिटेक्ट द आउटलायर्स येस दे आर अ डेटा क्वालिटी प्रॉब्लम बट यू टिपिकली detect them separately. That's the thing. Achha. Which method is used for encoding the categorical variables? Python mein do isme se zyada istemal hote hain. Kaun se hote hain?
Label encoder, one hot encoder.
Yeah, label and one hot. Actually, what they do is ke, they convert string to numerical. Ye basically inka kaam hi hota hai, theek hai? Label encoding mein directly ho jata hai. For example, if I have three values of string A, B, and C. So I will say, okay, A equals to 1, B equals to 2 and C equals to 3, something like that. One hot is more complicated, jo ki aap machine learning course mein aapko pata chal jayega. But in any case, just remember it right now. Ke these are the methods jo ke zyada istemal hote hain. Label and so the answer is A and B. I think ke Python mein dekhne ki zarurat hai whether category and quarter is also there. Let me just check right now. Because they keep on updating the API. I don't know. Yeah, so you see that there's also something which is called a category encoder. Haan, toh ye bhi wahi cheez hai. For encoding categorical variables, it, achha, who will tell me ke why do we need to convert string data to numerical data and data analysis?
Sir, because of the certain things that we do.
Ji, aur koi?
For certain analysis, we need them to be not be string because काफी चीजें हमारी string पे नहीं हो पाती.
Yeah, the machine learning algorithms do not accept string variables. ठीक है, that's the main thing. Machine learning जो algorithms हैं, वो string variables को they don't recognize them, so that's why we have to convert. Okay. Underfitting happens due to, what do you mean by underfitting? Underfitting, overfitting kya hota hai? That's part of machine learning वैसे.
Relationship.
Sir, वो हम data.
Look, मतलब ओवरफिटिंग ये होती है कि लेट्स से कि आई हैव सो इट्स समथिंग लाइक दिस लेट्स से ओके लेट्स से कि मेरे पास ये डेटा इस तरह का है आई हैव टू क्लासेस ऑफ द डेटा ओके एंड आई लर्न अ लाइन लाइक दिस So this is called overfitting. Overfitting का मतलब ये होता है कि when I am training ये please I don't know कि किसका है there's some child there probably. तो ये दो concepts belong to machine learning, but you can understand what is happening here. कि let's say कि मैंने आपको I give you the training data and you overfit. ठीक है You have a machine learning algorithm. आप regression problem कर रहे हैं data wrangling में आप regression problem कर रहे हैं for example. You are fitting a line to the data, and you primarily overfit. What do you mean by that?
Sir, basically data को training data को इतना overfit कर देना उसके हर parameters को कि जब आप prediction पे जाएं तो वो आप जरा सा भी मूव करें अपने डेटा जरा सा भी आने वाला डेटा जरा सा भी मूव करें अपने अपने रेंजेस से तो वो डेटा जो है ना सही प्रेडिक्ट नहीं हो पाता तो वो ओवरफिटिंग ऑफ डेटा हो जाता है
यस ओके लेट मी गिव यू एन एग्जांपल यू आर लर्निंग टू ड्राइव अ कार एंड योर डैड हैज अ कार ठीक है सो यू स्पेंड 6 मंथ्स ऑन दैट कार ओनली एंड यू लर्न एवरीथिंग अबाउट दैट कार बट यू ओवरफिट So when you go to the testing arena, when you go to license office to for giving the test, you fail miserably because the car is different. Okay, so you have learned how to drive, but you have overfitted. You learned only just one car, learned to drive only one car. You have not generalized. Samajh aa rahi baat ki? Do you get the idea? And if you don't practice too much on your dad's car just a few weeks and then you go and give the test so you have underfitted so you will fail even then so the point is ke when you are learning a machine learning model then you should neither overfit neither underfit both of these situations are extreme situations samajh mein aa rahi baat ki So when you will do machine learning, then you will understand that the model should not overfit and the model should not underfit. Okay? Is this thing clear? तो नाउ हैविंग अंडरस्टूड द कॉन्सेप्ट, नाउ टेल मी कि अंडरफिटिंग किस वजह से हो सकती है, कि मैंने मॉडल को लर्न किया ही नहीं है सही तरीके से. फॉर एग्जांपल इन दिस केस
एनालाइज रखी अपनी हर फाइंडिंग
का. हां जस्ट वेट, लेट्स से कि आई वांट टू डिस्टिंग्विश बिटवीन टू क्लासेस ऑफ डेटा. We'll take the break at 7 o'clock. Is it okay?
It's fine. I think it's something to do with B.
Ek minute. Main batata hun. So I have to learn to class distinguish between these two classes. Theek hai? So jo model main learn karta hun machine learning se, it's something like that. Is this line distinguishing between cross and circles? Huh?
No, sir.
But this is the line which distinguishes between cross and circle, right? Ke iske udhar cross circles hain, iske idhar jo hai crosses hain. But if I have this line, then obviously this is not distinguishing. Theek hai? So this is a very large, big case of underfitting. Maine kuch bhi nahi sikha basically. So why would that happen? Bhai, aap gaadi chalana seekh rahe hain, lekin आपने गाड़ी चलाना सही तरह नहीं सीखी, उसकी क्या वजह हो सकती है? एक तो ये वजह हो सकती है कि आपने ज्यादा ट्रायल्स ही नहीं की, ये हो सकता है ना.
yep.
दूसरी वजह ये हो सकती है कि रोड बड़ी खराब थी, गाड़ी बड़ी खराब थी. तो मशीन लर्निंग में अब इस तरह की चीजें लेके आए, तो इज दिस अ रीजन?
या आपने जहाँ गाड़ी सीखी वहां पे बहुत आसान जो था, आपने रियलिस्टिक वो हर्डल्स क्रिएट ही नहीं किए अपने लिए.
हाँ, that's also it. लेकिन मैं I am asking you के does the number of columns has something to do with that? कि मैं कहूँ कि अगर 13 columns होंगे तो underfit कर जाएगा, अगर 25 columns होंगे तो underfit नहीं करेगा. Does that make sense?
No,
that does not make sense. The number of features is depending on the business problem. It has nothing to do with that. मैंने कुछ और गलती की है. What about this one? Data has high variance. What does the variance mean?
Lack of what you call predictability basically.
Yes, बिल्कुल. Variance का मतलब क्या होता है कि data अपने mean से बहुत दूर है.
Yeah.
ठीक है. So yes, if the data is far away from the mean, then the normal distribution is probably going to be like this. Very strange sort of shape. ठीक है. So this could be a reason के अगर डेटा में वेरियंस ज्यादा है तो इट इज डिफिकल्ट टू प्रिडिक्ट दैट. भाई ये तो नॉर्मल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन का तो ये है ना कि डेटा अपने मीन के जितना करीब है, ठीक है, उतना ही वो रिलायबल है और प्रिडिक्टेबल है. सो अगर वेरियंस ज्यादा है तो इट्स नॉट, तो दिस कुड बी वन ऑफ द रीजंस. व्हाट अबाउट दिस वन? नो यूज ऑफ रेगुलराइजेशन. Does anybody know about regularization?
I can make a guess. I don't know.
Okay, regularization is a technique which is specifically designed to address underfitting and overfitting in machine learning. Uska maksad hi yahi hota hai ki underfitting or overfitting machine learning mein na ho. So yes, agar aap regularization use nahi kar rahe to underfitting bhi ho sakti hai और ओवरफिटिंग भी हो सकती है. अगर डेक्स यूज कर रहे हैं तो देयर इज अ एक्सट्रीम गारंटी के योर मॉडल विल नॉट अंडरफिट एंड नाइदर इट विल ओवरफिट. ठीक है. सो द आंसर इज बी एंड सी. रेगुलराइजेशन में वी गॉट डिफरेंट टेक्निक्स. इसमें दो किस्म की टेक्निक होती हैं, आप बस नाम याद रखें. एक होती है L1 व्हिच इज कॉल्ड लैसो रिग्रेशन एंड द अदर इज कॉल्ड L2 व्हिच इज कॉल्ड रिज रिग्रेशन. Now there is another one which is called elastic net regression, which combines both L1 and L2. So ab ye L1 L2 kya cheeze hain, abhi aap isko chhod dein. Aap for the sake of this diploma just remember ke we got a technique which is called regularization. So if you have a data scientist in your team, you can ask him ke yaar tumne regularization ki hai overfitting underfitting avoid karne ke liye. Sahi hai. You don't need to be knowledgeable about the internal details of that right now, but you should know that this is a very necessary technique in machine learning. Theek hai, sahi hai. अच्छा आप ओवरफिटिंग का बता दें शाबाश. Why would a model overfit? So I will just draw the. Okay, इससे बेहतर ये कि मैं आपको Google Images पे दिखा दूँ. That would be much.
Can be A and B.
Right. So let's take this example. So underfitting, it's a good fit here, which is a generalizable value. Now this is आपने एक ही गाड़ी को चलाना सीखा है, बाकी कोई गाड़ी आप नहीं चला सकते. That's the example of overfitting. So what could be the reason for such a model? So let's go back to this. जी.
Imbalance and noise.
What about variance?
Option C. Data has a high variance.
देखिए बीनिश प्रॉब्लम ये है कि इफ द डेटा हैज हाई वेरिएंस तो इट शुड बी डिफिकल्ट टू लर्न राइट. ऑन द कंट्रेरी आई एम लर्निंग इट वेरी वेरी गुड. मैं इतना जबरदस्त मॉडल लर्न कर रहा हूँ कि जिसकी कोई इंतहा नहीं है. सो इफ द वेरिएंस हैज अगर वेरिएंस डेटा की हाई है देन आई शुड नॉट बी लर्निंग दैट वेल राइट. क्या ख्याल है? वेरियंस का ताल्लुक अंडरफिटिंग के साथ तो इट मेक सेंस टू मी. But it does not make sense to me कि if the variance is high then I will overfit. क्योंकि overfit में तो it has learned extremely well. That's my logic. So I will look at this noise in the data. अच्छा noise. Noise भी अगर data में हो तो noise is a very it's not a very frequent activity, right? अगर noise है data में that is not supposed to be a very frequent thing. So why would it overfit? Overfit तो उस वक्त करना चाहिए जब एक ही तरह का डेटा हो and then it is going to be learning that very well. If it there is noise in the data, then I don't think so. It should be overfitting. So what is the imbalance in the data? Imbalance means what?
Like what you're saying, single type of data आ रहा है.
नहीं imbalance, right, not balance. It's an imbalance means के कभी कुछ आ रहा है तो कभी कुछ आ रहा है. So I can't associate that with overfitting either. It's a strange answer question.
Sir, if data mein high variance hoga, to aap ek dot se dot milayenge and basically aap model ko overfit karenge. Theek hai, aap usko zyada train karenge.
If I force it to learn it, to phir to overfitting ho sakti hai. But noise ke saath overfitting karna. I don't think so. Noise has something to do with that. Noise is, in fact, noise is something which you detect at the data wrangling stage. ऐसे ही है ना? Noise तो वो चीज़ है जो कि आप data wrangling stage के ऊपर detect करते हो. तो noise तो होनी नहीं चाहिए data में when you are learning the machine learning model. Noise should not be there. हाँ, imbalance हो सकता है. Imbalance में the data could be of different types, right? Different types of data आपके पास आ रहे हैं. कभी कभी किसी कस्टमर का पैटर्न आ रहा है, कभी किसी कस्टमर का आ रहा है. So how will we associate that with overfitting? I think मुझे तो अभी इसकी इतनी समझ में नहीं आ रही है. I think के जो बीनिश का रिस्पॉन्स है we'll have to go with that. This seems to be the most reasonable. और I'll just add here के if we train the model for a long time then it is supposed to बार बार हम ट्रेनिंग करते जा रहे हैं then it is supposed to overfit. Yeah, I can't associate these two conditions with overfitting of the model. ठीक है, so that's my response. So आप भी you are free to respond to that please.
सर आप चेक क्यों नहीं कर देते जब like probably end में जाके फिर हम सबमिट करेंगे तो वो रिजल्ट दिखा देगा मेरे ख्याल में.
नहीं वो आप देखें data scientist has should have your own perspective on things. This is not something which has come down from the skies, right? Hum abhi sochte hain but uske zehen mein kya baat hai. Maine because main online quizzes main kar raha hu dusre courses mein na and I have found ki there is a difference between how I am thinking and how that person is thinking. Isliye main responses nahi, we'll not check those responses at all. We'll just see ki what hame kitna aata hai. That's it. We don't need to check, chhod dein bas usko. क्योंकि हो सकता है उसने हमें रीजन ना बताई हो. अभी हमारा वो मकसद नहीं, अभी हम बस सोचेंगे, वी जस्ट नीड टू स्टार्ट थिंकिंग अबाउट इट, ठीक है, वो आप अपने एंड पे कर लीजिएगा, करना होगा अभी. आई डोंट वांट टू चेक एनी आंसर्स बिकॉज आई माइट नॉट एग्री विद द रिस्पॉन्स. तो व्हाई डू वी नीड फीचर ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन? ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन मीन्स व्हाट? लाइक फॉर एग्जाम्पल, आई हैव अ न्यूमेरिकल वैल्यू हेयर 1, 2, 3 एंड आई कन्वर्ट दैट टू स्ट्रिंग, और आई हैव अ न्यूमेरिकल वैल्यू एंड आई कन्वर्ट दैट, आई स्टैंडर्डाइज दैट टू अ जी स्कोर, or I have a string value and I convert that to a number. So why do we need that? Gee. is this one of the things I do in transformation? Hey, ji?
Option A.
This is one of the ways we transform, yes.
सर अभी आपने प्रीवियस एमसीक्यूज में एक्सप्लेन किया था, वो एक था ना डेटा रेगुलाइजेशन, तो सर ऑप्शन बी इज डेटा रेगुलाइजेशन ना, कि आपने रीसाइज किया फिक्स साइज के ऊपर, डेटा को स्टैंडर्डाइज किया.
कहाँ पे? अच्छा ये वाला रीसाइजिंग.
ये सर दिस इज बेसिकली वो जो आपने रेगुलाइजेशन बताई थी, दिस इज आई थिंक ये.
लेकिन यहाँ पे सवाल ये है कि why do we need feature transformation? So this is the reason, one of the reasons we need it. I might need to resize my inputs to a fixed size because I might be creating some new column. For example, if I have a product name like this, for example, let's say के Lipton tea. Lipton tea in the jug or 1 liter, something like that. So I will say ki yaar, this is too long a name for my data, so let's skip it down to lip j, 4 words. That means Lipton in a jug, there's just one jug, okay? So I might need to create this sort of a thing in the data wrangling stage to manage my data in a better way. So I will say both A and B. सही है, both of these are important. अगर आप इसे agree नहीं करते, बिल्कुल कोई मसला नहीं है. You are free to do that. हाँ जी, ये तो बताएं आप. Which of the following is true about outliers?
Both A and B.
Both A and B. बिल्कुल सही है. Obviously, ये दोनों चीजें तो हैं outliers, तो काम खराब करेंगे accuracy का. Imputation, that's about the missing value analysis. कौन-कौन से methods हैं?
All of the above.
Can I impute with random numbers?
Sir, not random numbers, but वो एक कोई particular number से आप analyze करके impute कर सकते हैं.
Yeah, so I can impute with a constant, right? So not random numbers. I can't impute with random numbers unless I'm doing something really, unless it's a column which is not very important to me. मैं उसको तो impute कर सकता हूँ random numbers. Why would I use random numbers? I mean, the minimum I do is that I delete the row, or I impute with the mean. तो पहले मैं row delete कर सकता हूँ या मैं mean या constant से replace करता हूँ. I never saw this option imputing with random numbers. No way, because if I impute with random numbers, it's going to destroy my distribution. ये तो मेरी उस कॉलम की probability density को खराब कर देगा. So I don't agree with this. And this is also not correct because imputing with one, you should say imputing with a constant value. Why would I always impute with one? This is not something which is generic. क्या ख्याल है? So I think this is the only option जो कि मेरे नजदीक है. If you say के all three, then you have to justify the response. ठीक है, उसको justify कर दें. Which algorithm does not require feature scaling? So this question is not good. So feature scaling. I think both of them don't require feature scaling. Feature scaling is in fact is a data transformation stage in which I can standardize the feature or I can put them in a certain range. Like between -1 to 1, so both of them could require it if it is needed. So this is feature scaling का मतलब बताऊँ ना आप लोगों को क्या है? Okay, so I'll just give you one example. So let's say here I have age. So the interval of age is between 17 and 87. So these are my customers' age. So the range is this, interval is this. Okay. Here I got sales. And the sales, minimum sales starts from 2500. So let's say, okay, 25,000. So you are a furniture shop, for example. Okay. 25,000 to let's say 125,000. Acha, ab mera aapse sawal ye, if I use both of these columns in my analysis, what is wrong? If I use both of these columns in machine learning or data wrangling, what is wrong in these two columns?
The variance in age and in sales will be large. Okay, 17, 37 age, so it's better how we categorize as a into 17 to 30, 30 to 40. इसी तरीके से इनकम को हम कैटेगराइज करें.
देखिए कुछ हद तक शायद आपकी बात सही है. The point is के this column is going to influence the machine learning or data wrangling activity more than this column. Because here the numbers are very small and here the numbers are very large. So I cannot allow a column to overwhelm other columns. You understand? So in this case, agar is tarah ka mamla ho, to I scale all numerical columns to be in the same range. ठीक है, ये आपको आप पता चल जाएगा machine learning के अंदर. तो this is the necessary transformation step. I scale all numerical columns to be in the same range. ठीक है, so for example I can put them in range -1 to 1. अब आप समझ में आ रही है? I mean the data is not going to change, but all of them will come in the same range. So koi bhi ek dusre ko influence nahi kar payega. Or I can do z score standardization. Samajh mein aa gayi baat ki? Is this thing clear?
Z score standardization mein
kya keh rahe hain?
What is the meaning of Z-score standardization?
Z-score का ये है कि if I have the value in a column, I subtract it from its mean and divide it by the standard deviation. That's called the Z-score transformation. और ये आपकी Python में भी available होती है. Let me show it to you. हाँ, ये देखें scipy.stats.z-score. ठीक है, सो वी कैन z-score स्टैंडर्डाइजेशन इन पाइथन. इसको इस तरह लिख लें, इसको कहते हैं स्टैंडर्डाइजेशन. सो यू सी के सब्ट्रैक्ट अ नंबर, सब्ट्रैक्ट द मीन डिवाइडेड बाय द स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन ऑफ दैट कॉलम. So यहाँ पर let's see how do you do that.
इसका मकसद क्या होता है standardization?
हाँ, मैं इसका मकसद ये मैं आपको ये बताना चाह रहा हूँ ना कि if I don't standardize the variables like I've shown here, so in any analysis which gets out of this training data, this sales column is going to overwhelm the analysis of the age column, especially when I do machine learning जिसमें सारे all the columns go in the machine learning algorithm. So the contribution of this sales, because the values of sales are in thousands. इसकी values of sales thousands के अंदर हैं और इसकी tens में हैं. You understand? इसकी values tens में आ रही हैं, इसकी thousands में आ रही हैं. So this column is going to have more contribution if I don't scale. So I don't want that to happen. I can't say that sales is more important than age. सही है, जस्ट बिकॉज के सेल्स की वैल्यूज हजारों लाखों में आ रही हैं, समझ में आ रही बात की? तो जस्ट अंडरस्टैंड. ये तो खैर अब वो जो वो डिटेल्स हैं तो वी कांट गो टू द डिटेल्स ऑफ दैट, बट आफ्टर ऑल आई हैव टोल्ड यू देन व्हाट डू यू थिंक इज द पर्पस ऑफ फीचर स्केलिंग इफ आई कास्ट देम इन द सेम रेंज विल दैट एक्सीलरेट द ट्रेनिंग टाइम Yes, sir. How come? Why would it generate better accuracy?
Because it can somehow a better way interrelate the both columns because of the we have rescaling the column depending on the
yes,
situation. For example,
हाँ देखिए हमने यही बात की थी ना कि if I don't rescale then this column is going to create problems for the other columns. ठीक है, इन मशीन लर्निंग वो कहेगा यार इसका तो कोई फायदा नहीं है तो टेंस में वैल्यूज हैं तो वी डोंट वांट दैट सिचुएशन टू हैपन. सो यस, बाय स्केलिंग इट इज क्वाइट पॉसिबल दैट आई विल गेट अ बेटर एक्यूरेसी. सो रिमेंबर इन मशीन लर्निंग मैं दो चीजें आपको अभी से बता दी. वन थिंग इज रेगुलराइजेशन टू अवॉइड ओवरफिटिंग एंड अंडरफिटिंग एंड वन ऑफ द अदर थिंग्स इज फीचर स्केलिंग व्हेन यू हैव मल्टीपल न्यूमेरिकल वेरिएबल्स. सो ऑल ऑफ दीस थिंग्स विल इंक्रीज द ट्रेनिंग टाइम, विल मेक योर मशीन लर्निंग मॉडल लर्न बेटर एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा. So the answer is C, both A and B. अच्छा ये स्टैंडर्डाइजेशन में अगेन टॉकिंग अबाउट द जी स्कोर ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन मैंने बताई. तो जी स्कोर ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन इज बेसिकली द स्टैंडर्ड नॉर्मल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन एंड वी हैव मीन जीरो एंड वेरियंस वन. सो व्हेन आई से के एक्स माइनस म्यू ओवर द स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन सो दैट्स कॉल्ड द जी स्कोर. सो जी स्कोर डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन इज एक्चुअली अ नॉर्मल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन which has mean zero and variance one. So that is the answer. You just remember this. That's a standard normal distribution. Even I don't know about this. What is a dummy variable trap? One variable predicts the value of the other variable. No, that's not a dummy variable trap. That's what we want. Multicollinearity among the dummy variables. What's a dummy variable?
Huh? स्कोर जो लगाते हैं एक डमी वेरिएबल बनाने के लिए अंडरस्कोर लगाते हैं.
ओके सो लेट्स लुक एट दिस
कोड लिख देते हैं.
अच्छा डमी वेरिएबल ट्रैप ऑकर्स व्हेन टू और मोर डमी वेरिएबल्स. अच्छा 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 ये दैट्स टॉकिंग अबाउट वन हॉट एनकोडिंग क्रिएटेड बाय वन हॉट एनकोडिंग आर हाईली कोरिलेटेड राइट. सो दैट्स गुड. ओके 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 ठीक है ठीक है. मुझे आई डिड नॉट इवन नो अबाउट दिस यार. Okay, so let me just go back here. So what he's saying here is ke so let me explain to you one hot encoding. So let's say I have a string column called age. Theek hai? And I have three rows. Let's say ke I have teens and I have adult. And I have old, and I have another teen, and I have another. So I have five rows here. Okay. And someone comes and says, "Okay, hey, I have to use this data in machine learning. So let us convert them to numerical values." Okay. So I say, "Okay, let's convert them." So I do one hot encoding. One hot encoding goes like this. It's going to create three more columns because I have three values of age. So A, teen. A adult and a underscore old. So these are called dummy variables. Okay. Now how to fill these values up? So when I have the value of teen in the row, I will just put this as one and the other two as G.
Zero.
Shabash. Because is row mein toh teen hi aa raha hai, theek hai? What about this one? What will I put here?
Zero.
And?
Zero.
One.
Zero.
And zero. Shabash. What about this one? Zero.
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 One.
Zero, zero, one. Haan, now you get the hang of it. So this is called dummy encoding. Okay. Again, in this case, this will be 100. And so adult will again be 01. The purpose is that I am converting string to numbers because machine learning understands numbers. And I have to do that at the data wrangling stage. Lekin ye maine aapko abhi isliye nahi padhaya because this is basically taught as part of machine learning. Unhot encoding, label encoding, feature scaling, feature transformation. So this could be data wrangling or this could be part of a machine learning course. So it's good that you are knowing about these things. Now, what is the trap? The trap is that one of the columns here is very, very highly correlated with one of the columns here. What do you mean by correlation?
Has its impact.
Correlation ka matlab kya hai?
Both variables are directly related to each other, so one changes, the other one will most likely change.
Very close to that. So extreme high correlation means ke a teen jis tarah change kar raha hai usi tarah a old change kar raha hai, to dono takriban barabar distribution lekar aa rahe hain. So now that's why is that a trap? Because that's a trap because I have two variables which are giving me the same thing. So do I need both of them?
No.
So I can just delete one of them and just use the other because their distribution is exactly the same. Trap ka matlab ye hai ki there is a very high level of multicollinearity. A teen is very highly correlated with A old. But na, aam taur pe jab aap wo kya kehte hain correlation nikalenge na, to it correlation is not very high, but a trap means ke you created extra columns and two of them are very highly correlated. So you don't need both of them, just delete one of them and use the other one. Okay, so that's a dummy variable trap, which is A. So keep that in mind. Okay. Acha, feature scaling mein Z score is a standardization technique. I can do that. Min max scaling is also there. So ye sari cheeze Python mein, I'll just show you there. All of these are just transformation functions, min max normalization, and let's say Python. So data normalization with pandas. Okay, so you can just so it's standardization is also there, normalization is also there. So this is the min max scaling formula that you can use. So this is just meant to do the feature scaling that I've already explained to you. Okay. So min max scaling option is obviously there. Standardization is the z-score standardization. Normalization is also there. So min max scaling is a type of normalization, in fact. So all these three are feature scaling techniques. Please keep this in mind. So all of the above is done. So you are getting to learn new things. You learned about the dummy variable trap. You learned about feature scaling. You learned about you already learned about regularization. Okay, so this is good for your knowledge. Ye to aap log bataye bhai. What is the characteristic of a good training data set? I've already told you this.
The grass is lower.
Nahi, dekhe. What is the first thing I told you about the training data? Wo kitna hona chahiye?
Option A.
या ऑप्शन ए बिकॉज
शेयर होना चाहिए.
कितने कितने साल का मैंने कहा था ट्रेनिंग डेटा होना चाहिए कम से कम मशीन लर्निंग के लिए या किसी भी सैंपल एनालिसिस के लिए? हाउ मेनी इयर्स?
मिनिमम 4 to 5 years.
मिनिमम 3 years. ओके, मिनिमम 3 years एंड 4 to 5 years इज ऑल्सो गुड. 5 साल देखें, इट बिकम्स अ बिट ओल्ड. 3 years इज अ सेफ लिमिट. The bias is lower. What do you mean by the bias?
Data कोई एक particular किसी specific location का ना हो, variability होनी चाहिए in order to predict the.
Yes, exactly right. The bias could be that if I have 10 different types of customers. So I get the training data for 7 customers and I don't get it for 3 customers. So I am being biased. Okay. And that is going to, that is not a good technique because when I get the testing data for testing my model, then obviously things are not going to be good because if the testing data contains those 3 customers, jo maine learn hi nahi kiye, then the accuracy of my model is going to go down. So whenever I have a sample, it should not be biased towards any particular entity. It should include all the entities jo ki aapke business mein chal rahe hain. So the answer is A and B. Yeah. Now tell this. How many are remaining? We've got to take the break here. Hurry up. Yeah, how to handle the missing values in the data set? Shabash.
A and B.
Who else? Anybody else?
A and B.
Anybody else?
A and B.
Correct. A and B is the right response. Let's go. The correct way of pre-processing the data should be pre-processing in another way of wrangling. Shabash. If there are missing values in the data, will you scale the features first or impute them first?
Impute A.
Yeah, option so A is one of the options. That is true. That is training the machine learning model. Any other option? Okay, so now this is definitely not an option because I can't impute later on. Okay. What about this one? Will you do the feature scaling first or will you convert string values to numerical first? Does it make any difference? Feature scaling is done only on numerical variables. Label encoding is done only on string variables. Does it make any difference? Kya pehle kaun sa karte hain?
Nahi.
So this is also correct. A and C is correct. Theek hai? What is a feature extraction example? Feature extraction means ke I got many features and all of them are not important for me. So I select a few of them. Which of these techniques helps me select a few features from a large number of features? There's just one technique listed here. Does imputation of missing values help me select features? Imputation has nothing to do with feature selection. Imputation is just missing, filling up missing values. Bag of words model, no way, because this is just a text analysis technique. So the answer is C. So this is a very famous technique, just come get them PCA. Just keep that in mind. And PCA is meant to select a small number of features given a large number of features because it's always better to work with smaller features than large number of features. You learn the model more quickly. And PCA is a very good feature selection technique or feature extraction example. Isko chhod dein because text mining is not something which is concerning us. Not in order to normalize the text data in text mining, we basically use we remove the stop words from the text data because they're very common. We create lemmas and we also stem. So I think the answer is D here. Yeah. But this is what stemming refers to in text mining. Stemming ka matlab hai ki reducing a word to its root. So for example, if I am saying running, so running is just the present continuous for run. So I take only the, you know, the root word. If I am saying gasping, okay, so the root word is gasp. So if I have to do any text analysis, then I just go with the root word. Okay, so that's called stemming. Natural language processing may the correct order I will tell you. First you tokenize, then you stem, then you lemmatize. You get tokenized stemming, and then you create the lemmas from the stemming. Because this is not part of the course, so I'm just giving you for your own knowledge. Bag of words is basically that you create a corpus of words. So this is in fact a feature selection technique. You can say no, it's not a. I'm not sure about this right now, but because it's not my domain of analysis. चले ये तो आप बता दें in text mining how the words lovely is converted to love. जी I just told this right now above.
Option A stemming.
Yeah, stemming, because stemming में you just remove the adjective, adverb, उसमें जितनी भी चीजें extra added ना, just go with the root word. That's called stemming. The root word is love here. ठीक है. What are the stop words? ये तो आपको वैसे पता होना चाहिए यार. What are the stop words in English language? हाँ? Come on, यार. जी स्टॉप वर्ड्स क्या होते हैं
तो आपको सेंटेंस खत्म करेंगे ना आपका
द वर्ड्स व्हिच आर फ्रीक्वेंटली यूज्ड इन द इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज फॉर एग्जांपल द एंड वी
पकड़ा तो इसके का होस्ट की करता था ये काम यानी क्या दबा दिया था इसने
एक मिनट रहेगा तो स्टॉप वर्ड्स कौन से वर्ड्स होते हैं
सो ए फ्रीक्वेंटली फॉलोइंग डॉक्यूमेंट
या डू यू थिंक दीस वर्ड्स आर इंपॉर्टेंट व्हेन आई एनालाइज एनी टेक्सचुअल कॉर्पस
नो
बिकॉज़ दे आर सो कॉमन आई कांट एनालाइज एनी डॉक्यूमेंट्स एनी टेक्सचुअल डॉक्यूमेंट बेस्ड ऑन स्टॉप बिकॉज़ स्टॉप वर्ड्स तो हर जगह पे हैं सो आई हैव टू गो फॉर अदर वर्ड्स दिस इज द रीजन के आई हैव टू रिमूव द स्टॉप वर्ड्स यहां लिखा होता ना कहीं पर Yeah, so the tokenization means ke write down every word separately. After this, we remove the stop words. Then we do stemming of the important words, and then we do the lemmatization. Okay, let's take a break right now, and then let's come back after like 10 minutes. Okay. What does mean?
Average.
Yeah, obviously, average. What about this one, middle?
Median is middle.
Ah, sahi kaha. Median is middle. Sahi baat hai. So, mean is the average. Mode.
Repeats the most.
Theek hai. Median.
Middle.
Which is not a data cleaning method.
Binary.
This is a difficult question. Data cleaning. So, सबसे पहले देखें data cleaning methods कौन-कौन से हैं. When I bin the data in a histogram, does that clean it? Wrangle phase में तो आता है ना वो. Data cleaning means data wrangling. All these three things are there to understand the data. Binning is a histogram basically. regression is basically a scatter plot in which I, you know, plot one variable y against the other variable x. So something like that. So I can do regression line fitting. It's also a machine learning technique. Clustering is also there to understand the data. Clustering may be yahi hota hai ke, in fact, clustering is part also of data wrangling. They can, it's a bit complicated concept. So isliye maine aapko bataya nahi. Theek hai, usko padhane mein aapko do teen classes chahiye. But clustering basically means ke I am just creating groups of the rows here. So iski jo sabse badi application hai, that happens in you know, when we want to discover the customer groups. So you're given this customer data and you want me to discover the groups of customers, how many types of customers I have. So clustering is the best application of clustering is this one. So typically what happens in the industry is we have either very expensive softwares which can do this clustering for us, but you know, it is not very easy to find these clusters of people, of your customers. Or dusra masla ye bhi hai ke the softwares, it is easy to buy the softwares, but it is difficult to use the softwares to do analytics. So discovering the groups of customers is a very difficult activity. You need to have very thorough knowledge of cluster analysis. So it does help you clean the data, as does regression and binning. But aggregation, what does aggregation mean?
Combine?
Nahi, nahi, bhai, kya ho gaya? When you made those plots in Python, the bar graphs, what does aggregation mean? What do you aggregate in the training data? Let me ask this. In a BI problem, given the data, what will you aggregate? Kis cheez ko aggregate karte hain?
Sales.
What? Haan, sales. So what is sales? Sales kya cheez hai?
Numerical column. We aggregate the numerical value. KPI, yes.
KPI, yes, that's what you aggregate. And across what you aggregate? Sales ka analysis kiske cross karte hain aap?
Age, gender, is that?
Why gender? Yeah, so across string variables. For example, product, that's called data warehousing. Yeah, BI mein aap padh rahe honge cheezein. Across product, across customer type, which is discovered through cluster analysis, across location. So that is called aggregation. Is this a data cleaning technique? Is this a wrangling technique?
No.
Gee, who else? Data wrangling techniques are basically binning, clustering, and regression. So yeah, they are part of data wrangling or data cleaning methods to understand the data. Aggregation is an analytics side of thing in which you generate graphs to basically tell the results of analysis. That is not data cleaning. So what is the answer?
Aggregation.
Yes, aggregation. Okay. Ye to bata de, abhi kiya ye. Which of these are normalization methods?
That is called normalization.
And?
Min-max normalization.
Yeah, so
decimal scaling normalization.
Haan, so it depends ke kon se offer ho rahe hai abhi to. Okay, you can say the first two. Binning, so I can bin by median and I can bin by means. I can also bin by bin boundaries. So all of the options are there. Okay, so that just yeah, be binning assembly, you just draw the histogram, you're not bothered with binning. Like in if you do that in SPSS, so it will allow you the option to specify ki bin kis tarah karna hai, binning by means karni hai, by media. So all is the answer to that. PCA full form is ye to abhi bataya hai pichle page pe.
Principal component analysis.
Yes, the first one. What is data discretization? Logical. जी
तो कन्वर्ट कंटिन्यूअस एट्रीब्यूट टू डिस्क्रीट एट्रीब्यूट.
यस बिल्कुल ऐसा ही है. डिस्क्रीटाइजेशन मींस आई कन्वर्ट न्यूमेरिकल डेटा टू स्ट्रिंग डेटा व्हिच इज डिस्क्रीट इन बाय नेचर. ओके वन हॉट एनकोडिंग लेबल एनकोडिंग कन्वर्ट्स स्ट्रिंग डेटा टू न्यूमेरिकल डेटा एंड डिस्क्रीटाइजेशन कन्वर्ट्स न्यूमेरिकल डेटा टू डिस्क्रीट डेटा. ओके concept hierarchy. Hierarchy is a concept which is used in data warehouse. Okay, just remember that. Data cube is an example of data aggregation because when you have multiple aggregations, you put them in a data cube. So that is data warehousing. Yeah, आपको BI में ये चीजें पढ़ानी चाहिए, पढ़ाई जाएंगी. आप उनको कहिएगा अपने टीचर को कि डेटा क्यूब्स के बारे में हमें बताएं और concept hierarchies के बारे में. Definitely वो I think के he or she will tell you about them. ठीक है. Okay, so this is a bit difficult again. Let's see, go through them. What is statistics?
Okay, so it's measuring how far apart two set of numbers are.
Yeah, basically you are right. I can also say it's also the study of data. Okay. जी अ कलेक्शन ऑफ इंडिविजुअल्स अबाउट व्हिच यू वांट टू ड्रॉ कंक्लूजंस. क्या होता है वो?
सैंपल.
यस अ सैंपल. वी ऑलवेज वर्क विद सैंपल्स. व्हाट इज इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट इंडिविजुअल्स इन अ पॉपुलेशन? हाँ, डेटा भी हो सकता है, स्टैटिस्टिक्स भी हो सकता है. बेसिकली स्टैटिस्टिक्स के थ्रू वी डिराइव नॉलेज ऑफ पॉपुलेशन. स्टैटिस्टिक्स इज मच बेटर बट डेटा. हाँ, इन्फ्लेशन एनालिसिस. बिल्कुल डेटा भी हो सकता है, दोनों हो सकते हैं. अ सबसेट ऑफ द पॉपुलेशन वी वांट टू कलेक्ट इन्फॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम. दिस मस्ट बी रैंडम टू अवॉइड अ बायस रिजल्ट. बहुत आसान है.
सैंपल.
या सैंपल. A quantity calculated from the data of the sample.
Parameter.
Yes, obviously. Because when we run the statistical test, then every test has a parameter. T test ka apna T parameter hai, ANOVA ka F parameter hota hai, and so on and so forth. Chi-squared mein chi-squared ka parameter hota hai. That's what we do. Normal distribution has the standard deviation. And the variance has parameters, so we calculate parameters. जी ये बताएं.
Census.
Sample.
So census.
Census is yeah, the collection measure for the whole census is much better. I think क्योंकि census जब होता है आप देखते हैं कि पूरे पाकिस्तान में होता है. So it's meant to target the whole population. ठीक है. This is very easy. Come on. पॉपुलेशन. ठीक है, ये तो बात आपको समझ में आवाज आनी चाहिए कि एवरी स्टैटिस्टिकल टेस्ट वी डू इज मेंट टू जनरेट इन्फरेंसेस अबाउट द पॉपुलेशन. सो पैरामीटर इज द आंसर. ठीक है. this one. जी
बॉय गर्ल कैट
सर लास्ट वन बॉय गर्ल एंड कैट होगा
नहीं 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 भाई बिल्कुल एक ही कॉलम में ये तीनों वैल्यूज का कोई तुक बनता है डज इट मेक सेंस टू पुट फाइंड आउट दोस व्हिच मेक सेंस टू पुट इन वन कॉलम
सर एक तो नाम ऐसे है वो समझ नहीं आ रहा टारगेट वॉलमार्ट पर भी
है टारगेट लेट एक मिनट लेट मी सी व्हाट इज टारगेट इज इट अ स्टोर
या
हां तो ठीक है ना फिर अब आप समझ जाएं आप अकलमंद हैं
वॉलमार्ट
ऑल दीस वैल्यूज आर रिप्रेजेंटिंग Super stores or hyper stores. So this could be. What about this one? Coke, salad, pizza.
What is the liquid to our animal soul?
So yeah, so both A and B could be the right answers. Liquid to Oedipus to hai na. ठीक है. What about this one?
Numerical data.
Numerical data, yeah, that's what you call it. Okay, discrete variable takes an exact number of values. So, what are the examples of discrete variables?
The number of students in a
number school. Of students in the school.
Huh. Yeah, you're right. That's the best example. Okay. Continuous can take values in a certain range.
The distance from Salem to Portland.
The distance from Salem to Portland. ठीक है चलें ये वाला
mean
yes that is the correct response. Middle of the data means the median. That's all you already know. How do you find the midpoint?
Highest number, lowest number divided by 2.
Yeah.
That no, is sir. No, sir. Midpoint, list number from low to high, find the middle number.
हाँ but the middle number could be two numbers. हाँ ये बात सही है यार सही कह रहे हैं sorry यार midpoint का तो ये मतलब हो सकता है
Yes, sir. First, we arrange the data from low to high. Then we.
Yeah, we have to arrange them first from low to high. That's the. नहीं तो बीनिश ने भी तो यही कहा है ना कि lowest plus highest. So I think both of these are right. The second one is for calculating the median. But the median might not necessarily by the midpoint. Midpoint का तो मेरे ख्याल में पहले ही आंसर होना चाहिए. हाँ, पहले ही आंसर होगा. Midpoint का पहले ही आंसर है. Because in the case of median, even if you sort the numbers, the middle number might be an average of two numbers. Sometimes you have to take the, sometimes you do get a middle number, sometimes you get middle two numbers. So in that case, you have to take the average, but that average is difficult, is basically this one. So yeah, find the midpoint. Chale, yahan masla hal kar dete hain. Dinesh, aap apna formula lagaiye.
सेवन माइनस वन सिक्स सिक्स डिवाइडेड बाय टू थ्री
है भाई क्या हो गया यहाँ पे क्या लिखा हुआ पर हाईएस्ट नंबर प्लस लोएस्ट डिवाइडेड बाय टू
एट फोर
नो सर फर्स्ट वी विल अरेंज देम वन थ्री फाइव सेवन देन वी विल टेक द टू मिडिल नंबर का दिस नंबर आर इवन देन वी ऐड फाइव प्लस सेवन ओह सॉरी फाइव या फाइव प्लस
फोर
बेसिक
Even that is by both the techniques you are getting four. 1357 में central number is 3 and 5 so divided by 2 is 4 so middle is 4 ठीक है.
Sir basically midpoint तो 4.5 होना चाहिए लेकिन there is no midpoint for this group basically ये होना चाहिए.
क्यों कोई midpoint नहीं? why not? 1357 का जो मिड पॉइंट है वो दैट इज एग्जैक्टली द वैल्यू 4, दैट इज द मिड पॉइंट. 567 हियर, 123 हियर, दैट इज द मिड पॉइंट इज 4. Why is not? It's not necessary that midpoint lies in this in these numbers. The midpoint could be any number between them. Okay. It's balanced on this side as well as on this side. So midpoint is 4. So this is very easy. What is the value that lies in the middle of the data when the data is ordered?
Median.
Median. And how do you find the median?
Option 2, list number from low to high, find middle number.
Find the middle number, which for which you might also need to take the average. How do you find the range?
Highest to lowest, subtract the range.
Highest to lowest ko minus karte hain, that is the range of that column, okay? Chale, iska median kya hoga? Shabash, jaldi batayein. Bhai, it is already ordered. Come on. 7 is the median. It's already ordered. Just find the central number. Okay. What is the difference called between the maximum and minimum data entries in the set?
Range.
The most frequently occurring value is obviously the mode.
Mode.
Isme kya mode hai?
No mode.
None. हाँ कोई भी mode नहीं है because all of them are unique values. ठीक है. And what about this one?
21, 19 by model.
Yeah, we have two modes here. Both are occurring twice. Range of this data.
35 minus 7.
Yeah. So what is that?
28.
28. Yeah. 28. That's right. चलें ये बताएं.
इंटरवल
मिड पॉइंट भाई ये तो दैट्स व्हाट वी हैव अभी तो ऊपर यही तो करते आ रहे हैं. दैट्स अ बिट डेफिनेशन ऑफ मिड पॉइंट. चलें ये बताएं.
All of the works.
I don't know what's a dot plot. What's a dot plot? Okay, dot plot is this one. Random values ka kitni frequency aa rahi hai, theek hai. So yeah, so all of them display. Stem and leaf is also kind of plots. All of the above. Chalein, ye to bahut asaan exercise hai yaar.
Outlier.
जी ये
स्क्रीन नीचे आपकी.
Come on. Distant, obviously. It can be distant. Identify the outlier here. Shabash.
7.
चलें. What kind of graph is this one?
Frequency histogram.
That's good. Chalein. So this is the mean, obviously. How many people have more than 4 books on their desk?
Three, four, five. No.
2, 4, 5. 9, 4, 5.
How many people have more than 4 books on their desks?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, sir.
हाँ, 7. देखिए 5 होंगी ना फिर. More than 4 books का मतलब 5 books हैं. तो there are 7 people, there are 7 crosses. So 7 is the answer. How many students spend more than 7 hours doing homework that week?
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight.
Yes, 8. So 8, 9, 10. 8 is the answer. how many total people took the survey?
110.
Is it 110? Could be 100.
What's that? 100. I did mistake in calculation.
100. So we just have to sum them up. Okay. How many employees are there that make between $33,000 and $43,000? So 33 and 43. So 500. I don't know. So now tell. Yeah, so between 33 and 40, 33 is this one. So how many employees are there? There's 500 employees. And 43 is, I don't know, maybe around 500 employees again. Between the, okay, so these are the ranges, 0 to 10, 11 to 21, 22 to 32, 33 to 43. So that is 500 people, right? So 500 is the answer. Describe the shape of this graph.
Uniform.
No, symmetrical.
Symmetrical is the answer, not uniform. Uniform distribution is like this, man. It has the same value across all the axes. Right? So you just cut them here, A to B. The uniform distribution has the same value all along. Just one probability. That's it. This is symmetrical. That's the normal curve. That's a symmetrical. Jitna left pe, utna right pe. What is the highest value of this stem and leaf plot? अच्छा इसको मैं आपको बता देता हूँ कि how to read this. Like when you have seen 11 and 0 na, so that means 110. 11-1 means 111. Okay. और इसी तरह 10 plus 0 means 100. 102, 103, 93, 94, 97, 81, 84, 85, 86. That's what it means. Stem and leaf का ये मतलब होता है, ठीक है?
111.
Yeah, so highest value is 111. Okay. Oh no, what about this 1,101? Is it possible here? No, that's not possible. I can't combine them that way. Okay? Describe the shape of this graph, Shavash.
Left skewed.
Anybody else?
Skewed to the right.
Left skewed.
Left skew, it's not right. Right skew goes like this in the normal distribution. This one, it has a long tail here. This has a certain long tail here. So it's sort of a left skew, somewhat left skewed. Okay. Can you retake the final exam? Oh, this is not important for us. Okay. So now we get to this. Okay. So now this is the box plot. Okay. This box plot displays the number of inches of snowfall last year for 14 cities. Median amount of snow that fell.
64.
Yes, the central line is the median. Shabash. What is the lower quartile?
7 almost.
Almost 7. ऑलमोस्ट सेवन, शाबाश, बिल्कुल ठीक है. द फर्स्ट लाइन हियर, ठीक है. व्हाट इज द इंटरक्वार्टाइल रेंज?
7-10
almost
3.5
around 3.
No, it's not 7. I mean, the lower quartile is 6.5, I think. 10 minus 6.5.
3.5.
3.5 is the answer, yeah. Okay. What is the formula for identifying the outliers when you use IQR?
Q1 plus 1.5 IQR.
Wrong. गलत है भाई, गलत है. यहाँ बताएं मुझे. Q1 से पीछे जाना है, Q3 से आगे जाना है. That's the answer. Which is the right answer here?
Q1 minus Q1.5 IQR.
And Q1 minus 1.5 times IQR identifies an outlier. What else? ये तो एक तरफ का हो गया. What about the right side?
Upper limit के लिए plus करेंगे. Q3 plus 1.5.
Yeah. So this is the answer and this is the answer. 1.5 times IQR is the range for determining the outlier, but they have to be done with respect to Q1 and Q3. What is the upper limit of the outlier range? अभी कर चुके हैं ऊपर.
Q3 plus
1.5 IQR, that gives the upper limit of the. In this case, for example, ये जो यहाँ पे dot आ रहा है, this dot here towards the right hand side, that's an outlier which is more than 1.5 times IQR from Q3. What percentage of data is between 40 and 90? Shabash. Weekly spending on groceries.
Almost 50%.
Yes, sir. Almost 50.
Okay, tell me what is Q1?
90.
90 का मतलब क्या है?
It's the lower quartile.
Yeah, so that means that 25% of the people have a weekly spending less than $90. But is what comes below the lower quartile is 25%. ठीक है? That's the interpretation. So the lower quartile is $90. That means that 25% of the people जिनको survey किया गया है, they weekly spend on groceries less than $90. So that's what he's asking. What is lies between 40 and 90? How much percentage of data? Gee, how much percentage of data?
25.
Of course, 25. What about the data which lies less than the median? How much total data that is?
50%.
That's 50%. It. So, अभी यहाँ पे क्या जवाब आएगा फिर 40 and 90 का?
25%.
Yeah. Identify the outlier. So this is the same question as the last 7. Which city, Nashville or Dallas, has the smaller median? Shabash.
Nashville.
दे कोई और? Smaller median किसका है? Dallas का या Nashville का है? Come on यार.
Sir, Nashville का.
Nashville का कम है. कितना है?
Sir, 50.
Around 50.
Yeah, around 50. ठीक है. अच्छा, 5 number summary जो हम create करते हैं, उसके अंदर क्या-क्या चीज़ आती हैं? Mean, mode, median, what else?
First quartile, third quartile.
I don't think so, because this is part of the 5 number summary. Ya hoti hai. I don't know.
Minimum, maximum? रेंज में कितनी
नहीं मिनिमम मैक्सिमम भी होता है
सर आई थिंक मीन
हाँ मीन नहीं होता यू आर राइट फर्स्ट क्वार्टाइल इज पार्ट ऑफ द बॉक्स प्लॉट थर्ड भी होता है मैक्सिमम भी होता है मिनिमम भी होता है mean is not there the median is there box plot only talks about median so yeah so that's the correct response which of the statements is true what is happening here okay ages of oscar winning actors from 1975 to 2004 so female have the median age around like maybe 30 32 or something like that and males have the median age 42 चलें अब ये आपके नाउ आंसर दिस क्वेश्चन चारों में से कौन सा सही है बी वेरी केयरफुल
Sir, it is unusual for female actors over 60 years old to win an Oscar.
अच्छा ठीक है और कोई बताए
ऑप्शन डी इट इज अनयूजुअल फॉर फीमेल एक्टर्स अंडर 50 इयर्स
हम स्क्रीन स्क्रॉल डाउन कर देंगे दिख रही है मुझे It is unusual for male actors under 40 years old to win an Oscar. Three, option three.
It is unusual for
male actors under 40 years.
अच्छा चलें मुझे बात बताएं कि ये what do you mean by usual and unusual in the case of box plot? पहले तो ये determine करें ना.
The probabilities.
Sir, they basically. तो बेसिकली जो मीडियन है ना उसके आसपास जो भी हमारे पास उसका मीडियन है दैट इज मोस्ट लाइकली उसकी तरफ उसकी उसकी पॉसिबिलिटी होती है तो मीडियन देख के हम यूजुअल और अनयूजुअल का पता लगा
अच्छा चलिए मैं अगर मैं आपसे सवाल पूछता हूँ कि इफ समथिंग लाइज विद इन द बॉक्स इज दैट यूजुअल और अनयूजुअल
यूजुअल
इफ समथिंग लाइज विद इन द विस्कर्स ऑफ द बॉक्स प्लॉट इज दैट यूजुअल और अनयूजुअल
Still, it could be a usual, sir.
Yes, still it would be usual. If something lies outside the whiskers, that's unusual. Unusual means the outliers.
Yes, sir.
Because box plot demonstrates a normal distribution. What lies within the box or within the whiskers is the usual behavior, which has been approximated. But what lies outside is the outlier, which is determined by the 1.5 formula. So in this problem, unusual is something which is the outlier. So the correct answer is, it is unusual for female actors over 60 years old to win an Oscar, which is the outlier range basically. सही है? जी
यस सर
आई मीन दैट्स द मोस्ट रीजनेबल रिस्पांस दैट वी कैन गिव ओके ओके ओ चलिए भाई ये करें आप लोग सो हाउ विल यू अप्रोक्सीमेट Q1 Q2 व्हाट इज Q2 Q2 इज द मीडियन चलिए पहले तो मीडियन निकाले ना व्हाट इज द मीडियन ऑफ दिस डेटा 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 13 Q2 क्या होगा पहले Q2 निकालें
15 होगा सर
Q2 is 15 Q2 is median right अब मसला ये कि इन चारों में सिर्फ एक ही ऑप्शन में Q2 15 आ रहा है सर वी कैन से कि दिस इज द आंसर राइट बट इफ आई आस्क यू टू अप्रोक्सीमेट दी हाँ तो देखिए वो तो बॉक्स प्लॉट करता है ना तो बेसिकली यू नो हाउ टू कैलकुलेट द मीडियन एंड फ्रॉम दैट यू फाइंड आउट द आंसर So IQR range, you can say IQR range, Q3 minus Q1, what is IQR? 16.5 minus 12.5, what is that? That is 4, right? So IQR is 4 and the range is 7. Why is the range 7?
18 minus 11 is equal to
18 minus 11 is 7. So that's the most evil, is reasonable response. Okay. True or false? Oh, this is very small here. 75% of the data values are greater than 18. So the lower quartile, I will tell you, it is basically, oh, even I can't see that. Yeah. Okay. So here we can see. So 75% of the data values are greater than 18. Is that right? हाँ ये आपका सही इम्तिहान है. जी How much percentage of values lie below the lower quartile? Yeah, we have no
question.
25%,
sir.
25% lie below the lower quartile, and how much lies above the lower quartile?
75%.
75%. बात खत्म हो गई. So 18 is what?
Lower quartile.
Yeah, 18 is a value which is very close to the lower quartile. So yes, this could be true. Because 25% usse kam hai, to 75% usse zyada hoga. Haan, nahi, 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 nahi. Dhyan rakhein. 16 is the lower quartile. Lower quartile is 16. So but which of these answers is true?
Sir, option two.
False, 75% of the values are greater than 16.
Of course. Bilkul sahi hai. Kyunki 25% values are lying here, less than this point. 75% values are lying here, greater than this point. In this way, in the upper quartile, 75% values are lying below this point, and 25% values are lying above this point. So it's basically you need to keep this thing in mind. So आंसर जो है वो यही है जो के भी दिया है. ओके ओ वाओ सो लेट्स डू इट हियर. द डेटा सेट दिस द नंबर ऑफ आवर्स स्पेंट ऑन द इंटरनेट इन अ वीक बाय द स्टूडेंट्स इन अ मैथ्स क्लास. चले जी शाबाश. विच बॉक्स एंड विस्कर प्लॉट्स रिप्रेजेंट्स द डेटा. वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग क्वेश्चन.
Sir, option two. Median is 10 or 10 is option. 10 जो है उसे 2 में आया था option two.
Okay, but cross check the other values as well, the maximum and the minimum.
Sir, scroll up करेंगे हम दिन
दिन. हाँ, तो minimum is 5, maximum is 19, so that is falling. So option two is the answer. चलें.
म्यूजिशियन सर.
म्यूजिशियन
जरा ध्यान से.
Musician.
That's a musician. Musicians पे तो हमें तरस आता है भाई. All the prophets who were sent down by God in this world were, most of them were sent down, you know, to teach the right thing, but also to terminate the music. ठीक है, म्यूजिक का जो आगाज हुआ था वो बेसिकली शैतान ने इंसानियत को सिखाया था कि दीज म्यूजिकल इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स आहिस्ता आहिस्ता वो उस तरफ लेकर आया उसको। और जो बंदा म्यूजिक सुनता है तो दिल में ना नफाक पैदा होता है, ये हदीस भी है। नफाक का मतलब ये होता है कि इट्स अ वेरी यू नो इट्स सॉर्ट ऑफ अ ब्लैक स्पॉट ऑन योर हार्ट विच मेक्स यू डू अदर बैड थिंग्स। सो इट्स अ कन्फर्म थिंग कि बाय लिसनिंग टू म्यूजिक योर हार्ट इज फिल्ड विद नफाक। ठीक है, सो हम डायरेक्टली तो नहीं किसी को कहते बट काइंडली डू ट्राई टू अवॉइड इट। It can never give you mental relaxation. हमारी human nature के खिलाफ है ये सुनना, although the whole world is dancing in concerts, ठीक है, but it does not give them any relaxation. I know about musicians जिन्होंने अपनी जान ली है, suicide किया है अमेरिका में और बहुत सारी जगहों के ऊपर, आप इसकी research भी कर सकते हैं। So kindly try to stay away from it. बिलाखिर तो हमने एक दिन मरना ही है ना। बहरहाल, विच हैज अ लार्जर आई क्यू आर,
स्टीवन
स्टीवन ऑब्वियसली। ठीक है, चलें स्कैटर प्लॉट
नेगेटिव।
नेगेटिव है तो इंटरप्रेट करें, यू गॉट द साइन लेजिबिलिटी डिस्टेंस वर्सेस द एज, व्हाट यू मीन बाय नेगेटिव?
साइन लेजिबिलिटी डिस्टेंस decreases as driver age increase.
So if I approximate this through regression, I will fit a line somewhere like this. So it's a negative trend. That's correct. ठीक है? Okay. चलें, fit a regression line. So let's fit a regression line to this. So if I fit a regression line, so it would be somewhere like this. That would be the line of best fit probably, or maybe a bit somewhat, let's see. ये कुछ होगा, अभी अजीब से लग बन रहा है। So Pam के लिए क्या आंसर बनेगा 6 का?
60, almost 60.
Almost 60 minutes, if I approximate this, ठीक है?
Yeah.
चलें. ये लाइन ऑफ बेस्ट फिट किस तरह आती है? रिग्रेशन के थ्रू। ठीक है, सो 180 मैन, 180 इज डायरेक्टली फॉलिंग। नहीं भाई, क्या हो गया है? 180 पेजेस डायरेक्टली फॉलिंग ऑन दिस लाइन
18।
ठीक है, 18 चैप्टर्स। चलें ये बताएं,
पॉजिटिव कोरिलेशन।
व्हाई
सर?
नेगेटिव कोरिलेशन, नेगेटिव।
नेगेटिव भाई, जितने ज्यादा लेयर्स होंगी उतने टेम्परेचर कम होगा ना।
सर हमें क्या पता आउटसाइड टेम्परेचर हॉट कोल्ड,
टेम्परेचर बढ़ता है तो
भाई लेयर्स, लेयर्स का मतलब ये होता है कि जैसे आपने अब वो मैं कहना नहीं चाह रहा, मुझे शर्म आ रही, लेकिन आपने पहले वेस्ट पहनी, फिर आपने अपने नॉर्मल कपड़े पहने, फिर आपने स्वेटर पहना, फिर आपने जैकेट पहनी, उसको लेयर्स कहते हैं. तो ऑब्वियसली when the temperature is less, the amount of layers is more. There's a negative correlation.
Sir, लेकिन यहाँ पे लिखा नहीं है temperature less है या ज़्यादा है. तो positive हो सकता है direct relationship पे temperature का number of layers के साथ.
भाई आप इसको इस तरह सोचें कि if I increase the number of layers, then definitely that means that temperature is decreasing. That's how you find out the correlation. You increase one and see क्या दूसरे पे क्या impact पड़ रहा है. That's called a correlation. ठीक है? It's negative. अब ये इसके बारे में मैं क्या कहूंगा, नंबर ऑफ सिबलिंग्स यू हैव एंड योर वेट,
नो कोरिलेशन,
नो कोरिलेशन.
अच्छा नेगेटिव होगा, नेगेटिव, वो ज्यादा खाना खा जाएंगे साथ में.
द नंबर ऑफ सिबलिंग्स यू हैव एंड योर वेट, सो इट कुड बी पॉजिटिव, इट कुड बी नो कोरिलेशन. ठीक है, सो इट डिपेंड्स ऑन द सिचुएशन. लेट्स गो अहेड, आई विल नॉट ड्वेल ऑन दिस टॉपिक. अच्छा ये क्या कह रहा है यार. हाँ चलें, एक लेट अस ड्रॉ द लाइन ऑफ बेस्ट फिट, लाइन ऑफ बेस्ट फिट
अराउंड 30,
नो
20 25
अराउंड 25, लेट्स 25 आवर्स इज द आंसर. ठीक है, अराउंड 25 आवर्स. सो यू सी द इफेक्ट ऑफ स्कैटर प्लॉट, राइट? द स्कैटर प्लॉट एंड रिग्रेशन गो हैंड इन हैंड टुगेदर. ठीक है चलें, शाबाश.
पॉजिटिव कोरिलेशन,
दैट्स अ पॉजिटिव,
ऑब्वियसली पॉजिटिव कोरिलेशन. चलें, ओ चलें याद रहे. नाउ व्हाट डू वी से हियर, डज नॉट लुक, इट सीम्स पॉजिटिव बट इट्स नॉट एग्जैक्टली पॉजिटिव जैसे होनी चाहिए. Like I could also have this quadratic some sort of thing relationship, but let's say I form a straight line. So straight line will be very strange, like somewhere like this. So let's see the.
So it's a positive. It's a positive.
तेरे answer क्या होगा?
Answer one. The further you run, the further you jump.
ठीक है, that's also logical conclusion. ठीक है, सही है. चलें, find the slope.
That's 1 upon 2.
Obviously, 3 minus 2 over 4 minus 2, that's the slope. ये तो आप लोग आना चाहिए formula.
Y2 minus Y1 divided by X2 minus.
Linear regression.
नहीं भाई.
Line of best fit.
Yes, it's called the line of best fit. That's what I've been using the name in this video right now. The line of best fit is that the best fit which minimizes the error. Okay.
C.
C is that's right. C represents the linear relationship. Now this tell.
No correlation.
Why?
Line of best fit draw कर लेते पहले.
Data is scattered.
So very very scattered data.
There is lot of variation in the data.
But even not this one. Let's say this is the line of best fit. जितने points ऊपर उतने नीचे, that minimizes the error. So what's wrong? This seems positive, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
No, sir.
अच्छा चले
जरा वन से ड्रॉ करें वन पे
इट आल्सो सीम्स नेगेटिव सही है सो देयर इज नो कोरिलेशन इट्स टू मच वेरिएंस ठीक है टू मच स्कैटर कांट से
B
is this one.
C. 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 C.
ठीक है. Correlation zero है क्या करेंगे
no predictable pattern
sir it has no ordered pair अगर correlation नहीं है तो no ordered pair
ordered pair से उसका ताल्लुक ही नहीं है ordered pair से क्या ताल्लुक है आप general बात करें
sir no predictable pattern
देखें ordered pair क्या चीज होती है ordered pair से तो हमारा कोई ताल्लुक ही नहीं है हमने तो सारे points plot कर दिए
बट सर ऑर्डर पेयर के जरिए हम ये तो बता सकते हैं ना x की वैल्यू ये है तो उसकी y कॉलम पे ये वैल्यू होगी तो वो
ऑर्डर पेयर जो बनाते हैं इट इज टेलिंग यू कि देयर इज नो एसोसिएशन देयर इज नो कोरिलेशन सो दिस इज द आंसर इफ देयर इज नो कोरिलेशन आई कैन मेक अ लाइन ऑन अ ग्राफ और यू नो अ क्लाउड ऑन अ ग्राफ देयर इज नो कोरिलेशन सही है मेरे लिए तो ये आंसर है अब आप लोग उसको जस्टिफाई कर दीजिएगा चलें शाबाश हाँ बिल्कुल सही है बिल्कुल सही है चलें दिस इज वेरी इजी है तो बच्चों वाला है इज अ पॉइंट दैट इज फार आउटसाइड द मेन क्लस्टर ऑफ पॉइंट्स बाय ऑर्डर्ड पेयर्स ठीक है Okay, so now the line of best fit के बारे में is asking के what is the best description about the line of best fit? चलें. What is the best description?
The more books a student read, the higher their English grade.
Yeah, that's pretty simple, and that's the correct answer. Possible line of best fit for this data? कहाँ रह गए कमॉन
तो लाइन को देख के स्लोप को कैसे पता चलता है? यानी अगर मैं बेस्ट फिट लाइन बनाऊं तो हाउ वुड आई गेट टू नो व्हाट द स्लोप?
यू जस्ट टेक टू पॉइंट्स. एक्चुअली द लाइन ऑफ बेस्ट फिट नीड्स टू पास थ्रू सम ऑफ द पॉइंट्स सो दैट यू कैन यूज देम टू एप्रोक्सीमेट द इंटरसेप्ट. बट एक चीज आप याद रखें, बिकॉज दिस इज अ नेगेटिव कोरिलेशन, सो द स्लोप इज गोइंग टू बी नेगेटिव. सो दिस कैनॉट बी द आंसर, दिस कैनॉट बी द आंसर. इन दोनों में से कोई आंसर होगा. जस्ट बी अ लिटिल बिट इनोवेटिव. ओके, सो नाउ इफ इट इज इक्वल टू वाई इक्वल्स टू माइनस एक्स, दैट मीन्स के टू पे वाई इक्वल्स टू माइनस एक्स का मतलब क्या है कि व्हेन एक्स इज माइनस टू, अच्छा माइनस एक्स प्लस 19, सॉरी अबाउट दैट. वाई इक्वल्स टू माइनस एक्स की लाइन कहाँ से गुजर रही है? So 2 something like that. It's somewhere like here. That's y equals to minus x. ठीक है. Plus 19. I think this makes more sense to me.
As compared to 19 is a y intercept. 19 के साथ होना चाहिए. If x was 0, then it will actually hit 19 is the y intercept.
हाँ, that seems to be reasonable as well. ठीक है, so this could be a possible answer. You must know how to approximate this ताकि थोड़ा सा हमारा clarity आ जाए. ये जैसे अब आपकी practice करवा रहे हैं ताकि चीजें मज़ीद clear हों. How much is remaining यार? Oh. Okay, so what is the population? So you have to estimate the equation of the line first. So the gradient is 85 minus 29, which is 56 over 7, which is 8. Y equals to 8x plus 25. Say, yeah. So the value of x is 15. 8x plus 25. 15 into 8 is what? 120 plus
25.
145. That is 150 almost. So 150 is the answer. ठीक है? After 15 months, 150 is the answer. Let's see. जल्दी जल्दी इसको कर लें. Okay, so what is the possible line of best fit for this data? Y-intercept से अंदाजा लगा लें. Y-intercept can only be, it cannot be zero. It can only be 470 or 490. 490 is going to be very close to this one. 470, 470 to nahi ho sakta, because if I draw the line of best fit, it's going to be somewhere like this. I mean, if I try to minimize the error logically, so it's going to be somewhere like 490, definitely. 470 is going to be here, and that means that the line of best fit will be like this, which is not exactly reducing the error. So line of best fit bahut hi jiske upar niche dono balance ho jaye cheeze hain, sahi hai? That is the one जिसमें हम कहते हैं कि error आपका कम हो गया है. So okay, correlation, can you describe it? Strong positive, weak positive, strong negative, weak negative.
Strong positive.
Yeah, strong positive, because they almost all are all lying on the straight line. So yeah, that is true. What about this one?
This is
weak negative. Yeah, weak negative, because they will not lie on the straight line, but rather distributed around that line. ठीक है? जी.
To make predictions.
To make the graph look pretty, that's really absurd, yeah. To make predictions, yeah. That's what is a scatter plot?
A graph that shows the relationship between two data set.
Yeah, that's true. So Mrs. Collins has done what? Number of absences and students' final exam score. Obviously, jitni absence zyada hongi, score kam hoga. So that's a negative correlation. with six abscesses should get how much score? So let's draw the line of best fit here. Just an approximate one, somewhere like something like this. And 6, 7, 6 is somewhere like this here. So that's equivalent to like 70 something, right? 70, so probably 70. Just approximate up, usko approximate kar le. Okay, so this one is finished. So what do you think? Should we take a small break again?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay, so okay, just let's take a small break and just come back after 10 minutes. True or false? Okay, what's the first one? Imputation is just making up data to artificially inflate results. It's better to just drop cases with missing data than to impute. What is the answer?
False. False.
Yes, it's false. Imputation is one of the better methods, in fact. I can just impute the mean for any missing data. It won't affect the results and improves power.
False.
Yeah, I can't impute for any missing data because it's only for the numerical values, right? It's not for the string values if they are missing. And this is wrong. It will affect the results, obviously. It does affect it does affect the results in a better way. So this is also false. Multiple imputation is fine for the predictive variables. Ye to aap bataein. Predictor variable, response variable is what you want to predict, basically. Let's, for example, the sales. You want to predict the sales. Or you want to predict the age of the customer, for example. So that's the response variable. And all the other are called the predictors. So imputation is fine for the predictive variables, but not for the response variable. What do you think? If there are missing values in the age variable, should we use imputation for that?
Yes, sir, we can.
We can. So this is also false. This is wrong because imputation obviously is a better method for any numerical column. Multiple imputation is always the best way to deal with missing data. Chale, bhai, ye to ab aap bataye. Ye to nazariyati baat hai. Ji.
Sir, it's again depend on the how much the values are missing. If they are less than 10%, then somehow we can do. Otherwise, not.
Why? It depends on that. I mean, ye pooch hi raha hai ki, is it always the best method to deal with missing data? We talked about it when we were discussing ke imputation is a very good method. But is it always the best way?
But sir, it's asking about the multiple imputation. It means by applying the multiple methods of imputation on a single data, to cope up with the missing data.
Yeah, multiple imputation means, I think this is what it means. If in this column I have missing values, so I impute these missing values based on the data in multiple columns. For example, this is A, this is B, this is C. So I will use the data from A, B, and C, correlation data, for example, to fill up the values here. That's called multiple imputation. Yeah, so that's what it is. So do you think it is always the best way? Yeah, I don't think it is always the best way. Sometimes you might want to use the mean for some reason. So this is also false. Alhamdulillah. When imputing, it's important that the imputations be plausible data points. What do you mean by that? Plausible data points. So how can I ensure that? Because, sorry, if I, yeah. So how can you ensure that this these are plausible data points. I can never ensure that, right? I don't know if values kahan missing aa jaye, kis wajah se aa jaye. I have no idea about that. So how can these be, these can be plausible data points. So I think this is also false. I can't really say for sure. Answers, they're all false, man. So missing data isn't really a problem if I'm just doing simple statistics like chi-square and theta. That's false. Obviously, it's a big problem. The worst thing that missing data does is lower the sample size and reduce the power. That's also false. So all, everything is false here. So there's no problem.
Sir, can you tell us about the final exam?
Yeah, so we, I'm discussing the final exam right now. Ye final exam hi chal raha hai aapka.
Okay, so this is a fun exam of today's class.
Nahi. This is, I mean, these are the kind of questions that you might expect. Okay, the final exam,
sir,
is...
Yeah, I have a 140. We don't get the remarks of this assignment that we submit.
I will do it because main ab inshallah aapko next week mein iska dunga kyunki abhi hamare classes, I mean, we are having exams right now. ठीक है, so अब हमारी classes नहीं होंगी तो मैं आपको definitely दे दूंगा, आपको Tuesday तक इंशाल्लाह दे दूंगा. I just have to spend one day on that. I will give them to you. I am receiving all the emails. We'll discuss about the exam. The first, let us do this. This is important. Okay, ये पहले कर लेते हैं. What is skewness?
Sir.
Sir, skewed is like आपका डेटा या आपका ग्राफ किस तरफ जा रहा है?
नहीं तो इसमें से बताएं ना, which option is there?
अच्छा sir.
Option C.
Lack of symmetry. This is symmetrical. And this is left skew, and this is right. This is the right skew. So these are not non-symmetrical. Okay. What happens if you raise a variable to the power less than one? So if I have x. But I say x to the power 0.5. What happens to x? X will somewhat decrease, right? This is wrong. Obviously, the data will not stay the same. So I raise it to the power x squared is supposed, if I do a square greater than 1, then what is supposed to happen? It will go like this, y equals to x squared. Y equals to x is like this, y equals to x to the power half is supposed to be what? It's supposed to be the other way around, like this one. Okay. So like this one probably. So I don't know. We will reduce the positive skew. Okay. So y equals to x to the power 0.5 ka graph kaisa hota hai? First envision that. How can we reduce the positive skew? Achha, ek minute hai. Toh main kehta hun, y equals to the x to the power 0.1. So x ki value is going to be reduced, right? So if I have some value probabilistic here, then the value of y is going to decrease. So that, if I have larger values of x which are, let's, which are creating a skew, so this an outlier is creating a skew, for example. This is some point which is creating this skew on the probability density curve. Let's say it has a value of 1000. So if I raise it to the power less than 1, so obviously it is going to come back, right? When it is going to come back, the probability is also going to come back. So in that case, it is going to reduce the positive skew. I did not mention that. So what does regression do? I think A is the answer to that. Oh, it gives a way. It's a robust regression. I don't know what is robust regression. It gives a weight to each unit based on their total influence on the model. Okay, which of the following is recommended to use when running an analysis with missing data? Shabash. So it could be
single imputation.
It could be either B or C, but you can never be sure. So it's B, multiple imputation. Okay. What does multiple imputation do? जी
बी यूजेस
बी और सी
हाँ बी और सी लग रहा है क्योंकि हमने एग्जैक्ट किया नहीं है सो इट्स बी बेसिकली ठीक है ये सारे दूसरे से कर ठीक है ये भी हो गया सो लेट्स स्किप दिस अनोवा में चले जस्ट टेल दिस अनोवा व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन अनोवा एंड टी टेस्ट
Option D, I guess, NOVA is about the mean and t-test is about basic.
No, analysis of variance. So, ANOVA is about the variance, in fact.
Yes,
and
yes,
t-test
yes.
is about the mean. So, ye ulta likha hua, so this is wrong.
Yes.
I think this is the answer. ANOVA stands for analysis of variance. तो ये खैर हमने इतनी डिटेल की नहीं है सो दिस अच्छा सो नाउ अबाउट द एग्जाम राइट अच्छा हाँ एक और चीज रहेगी विच इज कॉल्ड द क्यू क्यू प्लॉट देखें जस्ट लेट मी राइट इट डाउन हियर सो जस्ट सॉरी अबाउट दैट अबे यार जस्ट लेट मी गो फॉर इमेजेस Right, so now let me write it down. Okay. The QQ plot is used is a univariate plot. Let me just go on a single numerical column. Okay. And is used to determine whether the data in that column is normal or not. If the data lies very close to the line y equals to x, then the data in that column is normal. ठीक है ये उसका basic असूल है so for example you can see के this QQ plot this is the line y equals to x and the data is going somewhere like this so this is not exactly normal. Similarly, this data is jumping like this, so this is not exactly normal. On the contrary, you can see that this data is lying mostly on that line, so this is normal. So QQ plot is a very good method of determining whether your data is normal or not. Uske alawa, you can have the probability density curve, you have the box plot, you have the histogram, and you also have some statistical tests jo aapne kiye hain, jaise Anderson, Shapiro-Wilkinson test and the Anderson test. So all of these things should be there. To help you understand whether your data is normal or not. Yeah. Now about the final exam, I'm going to be giving some questions like we did. We did lots of numericals today.
हाँ मैंने किया था दो sessions सारे मैंने किए थे उसके बाद शायद मुझे response नहीं आया मैंने कर तो दोबारा नहीं किया मैंने.
Okay, so I just muted everybody. Apologies for that. In the final exam, I'm going to give you some numericals and some probably some multiple choice or some theoretical questions as we did today regarding the box plots, regarding the scatter plots, regarding the cleaning processes, regarding the wrangling strategy that I explained in the last class, regarding many things, right? There's small questions based on testing your concepts. Aapne exam ke andar you have done the aggregation plots as well. You have done the missing value analysis. You have done the statistical t-test, chi-square test, and ANOVA test. You have done the box plots and the histograms. You have done all the basic things. Today, we have covered regression as well. And we have also done things about overfitting and underfitting and regularization. Because all of these things are included in your syllabus. Whatever we have covered, everything is included in the syllabus. I might also give you some Python code and ask you, kis mein kya ho raha hai? So the exam is going to be like 3 hours or 4 hours, but you have 1 week to solve it. Ab apne aram se ghar pe kare, it's a takeaway, take home exam. Just try to solve it yourself. Please don't think about cheating or copying. Okay? It's not going to work. So there are going to be lots of conceptual questions, and you will only learn when you will attempt the exam properly. So aaj humne alhamdulillah exercises ki, I think that has built up the tempo for all of us. So you will be able to answer most of the questions which I give. I'm not going to be giving complicated questions about ANOVA, but I might be giving a table or usme main keh sakta hu ki yaar is table pe ANOVA is giving this result, so what does that mean? So you should be able to interpret all of that. If you have done the labs, I will give you the chance to complete the assignments, all of them, the Python assignments. That will prepare you well for the exam. And also go through today's video, and inshallah you will learn. I think that's what I needed to tell you. Any other questions?
Sir, when will you take the exam?
Today is Saturday, right? So I will give you 2 or 3 more days to complete your assignments till Tuesday. I am hopeful that by Tuesday, I will give you the results of all your previous assignments. So that will, and then maybe on Wednesday, I will give you the exam. For example, I can give you the exam on WhatsApp on, let's say, Wednesday, like say 3 o'clock or something like that. And then you can give back the exam to me. You have to email it to me by Wednesday night or something like that. Or maybe if you want more time, you can take more time. जब मैं एग्जाम दे दूंगा तो उसके 4-5 घंटे के अंदर अंदर आपको देना होगा. दैट्स द पॉइंट. सो आप लोग मुझे खुद बता देंगे कौन सा दिन आपके लिए बेहतर है.
सर मैं समझा नहीं, आप एग्जाम दे रहे हैं व्हिच इज वी कैन डू ओवर अ वीक. हां देखिए, सम पार्ट ऑफ इट व्हिच इज गिवन द सेम डे
एक्चुअली. हां सॉरी, मैं आई गॉट कंफ्यूज मायसेल्फ. देखें फाइनल एग्जाम है ना, तो आई विल प्रिफर टू हैव अ डे इन विच आई गिव द एग्जाम एंड देन यू हैव सेवरल आवर्स इंक्लूडिंग 5 to 6 आवर्स, बट यू सबमिट ऑन दैट सेम डे. दैट इज प्रिफरेबल टू मी. आई डोंट थिंक सो द एग्जाम शुड बी टेकन ओवर द अदर डे, बिकॉज इफ यू अटेम्प्ट द एग्जाम यू अटेम्प्ट इट वंस, राइट? यू कांट अटेम्प्ट द एग्जाम. इट्स एन एग्जाम, राइट? सो I will prefer कि आप एक ही सेटिंग में उसको करके दे दें, but I'm willing to extend the time to 5 or 6 hours or 6 or 7 hours. ये मैं कह रहा हूँ. So which day is good?
So it's not the
time, sir.
अच्छा, अगर आप लोगों के ऑफिस का मसला है फिर तो बेहतर यही है कि यार आप फिर मल्टीपल डेज पे कर लें, आप थोड़ा थोड़ा रोजाना करते रहें, ठीक है? क्योंकि इस तरह भी नेक्स्ट संडे तो बहुत देर हो जाएगी यार, ठीक है? सो देयरफॉर आई विल गिव यू द एग्जाम एंड देन यू कैन टेक मे बी 2 to 3 days. 3 days मैं दे दूंगा आपको, ठीक है?
सर ये सही रहेगा, बिल्कुल
सही रहेगा. ठीक है, सही है. दैट्स बट देयर गोना बी मेनी क्वेश्चंस, तो ठीक है, 3 days इज ऑलरेडी जस्टिफाइड.
Three days to finish.
तो आपके पास ओपन ऑप्शन है, आप सब कुछ कंसल्ट कर सकते हैं, बट प्लीज लर्न थिंग्स, जस्ट लर्न द थिंग्स, ठीक है?
सर आप ये ट्यूसडे के बाद इश्यू करेंगे एग्जाम?
जी, बिल्कुल, आफ्टर ट्यूसडे डेफिनेटली.
अच्छा, ट्यूसडे को लास्ट असाइनमेंट सारे जो हैं वो आप सबमिट कर,
हां ट्यूसडे को प्लीज आप ट्यूसडे तक आप मुझे सबमिशन करा दें. आई थिंक दैट विल बी रिकमेंडेड.
अच्छा, और ओके ओके, और ट्यूसडे वेडनेसडे तक आप बेसिकली फीडबैक दे देंगे बाकी असाइनमेंट्स पे?
हाँ बिल्कुल,
ठीक है,
ओके. एंड सर, हाउ मच द फाइनल एग्जाम कंट्रीब्यूट टू द to this course?
Overall score?
Look, your assignments are going to be having a good weightage. So I guess it should be around 30% or 35%. And the rest are going to be distributed over the assignments.
Okay.
Okay.
We will learn. All of us will learn.
Yeah, that's true. That's true.
ठीक है चलें चलें फिर सही है ठीक है I will just upload the video and then you can just look at it and then let's work over towards the final exam ठीक है
चलो भाई
okay assalamualaikum
thank you sir waalaikum assalam